81-year-old sister Rogine Fox was suffering from severe back pain until she agreed to test a popular treatment. She believed it worked.
I just thought, thank God, I don't care what I received. I feel good. I don't have pain.
But it turns out she got relief without getting the procedure, called vertebroplasty, a common treatment for patients with painful back fractures from osteoporosis. Today, two separate studies in the New England Journal of Medicine report there was no difference up to 6 months later for patients who actually had the procedure and those who had a fake or placebo treatment instead.
I thought, wow, we're on to something. So we saw many placebo patients get full pain relief. I have no idea why.
During vertebroplasty, doctors inject medical cement into fractured bone in the back to strengthen the area and reduce pain. The placebo was just a shot to temporarily numb the area. Vertebroplasty is endorsed by multiple medical societies, but the surprising findings may force doctors to rethink the treatment.
I was quite amazed. Vertebroplasty is one of the most rewarding procedures I do, and to take that and say that it doesn't work, to me, I just have a hard time digesting that.
Cool. It's a moneymaker for specialists. In recent years, the number of these procedures has doubled to at least 40,000 annually, each one costing $2,000 to $5,000.
Patients must be empowered to make decisions based on best evidence.
These results point to the kind of savings President Obama has said can be achieved when there are well-designed studies on whether expensive treatments really work.
There's a whole lot of care that's not improving health. And my main focus is on how we can stop putting money into things that aren't making people healthier.
These two studies, I think, represent great examples of the kind of work the president's looking for.
This is a good bone.
But it remains to be seen whether physicians will change their behavior based on this new evidence.
Everybody says they want evidence-based medicine. Sometimes the evidence is not what you asked for.
It's one thing for patients and doctors to believe a treatment works. It's another to know the facts. That's why Congress has earmarked $1 billion to study the effectiveness of many different treatments. Katie.
Dr. Jon LaPook. John, thanks very much.